You might not believe this, but the Marksman rifles are actually one of the hardest weapon categories to unlock priceless camo for in Modern Warfare 3. For some reason, almost every weapon in this category is near useless, with only 3 of the 5 weapons having the ability to one-shot headshot, and just one of them, the Kar98K, is able to one-shot kill to the body. This means you are pretty much outgunned in every fight you take, and to be honest, even pistols will probably out-DPS you. So yeah. Getting camo challenges done on these weapons is not as easy as you might think. I'll be sharing with you my best tips and class setups for unlocking every single camo on the Marksman rifles, all the way up to priceless. But honestly, if you're going for Interstellar, my best advice is to skip this weapon category entirely, as there's enough weapons in the game now to make this possible. If you are sticking around though, then first of all, I appreciate you a lot. Second, let's get started with the base camo challenges, as they are the same for every single weapon in this category. And for these, you need to get 50 kills, 50 headshots, 10 bare bones kills, and 2 kills without dying 15 times. The 50 kills and the 2 kills without dying are self-explanatory and very straightforward, so there's no need to go into any detail for these. The bare bones kills are kills with no attachments on the weapon, which can be fairly difficult as you can't use a sight, but ultimately it is only 10 kills before you can put your attachments back on, so again, a pretty easy one. And then there's the headshots. The difficulty of this challenge is entirely dependent on the weapon you're using. The KVD Enforcer, MTZ Interceptor, and Kar98K all have the ability to get one-hit kills to the head. So when you're doing these ones, the headshots challenge isn't too bad. Just take your time with your aim, and try to consciously only pull the trigger when you know you've got a headshot lined up. Of course, if you come across any AFK players, then make sure you take that free headshot. However, the MCW 6.8 needs 2 headshots to kill, or a body shot and a headshot at any range. The DM56 needs 2 headshots to kill within the effective damage range, or 2 body shots and a headshot to kill, which is very difficult to achieve with a semi-auto weapon. Luckily for getting headshots with these two guns, you've got 2 options to make your life much easier. The first option is to jump into hardcore, as that now means both of these weapons will one-shot kill to the head, so my previous advice now applies again. You do have to be a bit quicker to take your shot in hardcore though, as you die much, much faster. Option 2, and this is my preferred one as it means you can stay in the core playlist, is to use these class setups. Both the MCW 6.8 and DM56 have really nice aftermarket part conversion kits. The MCW one turns it into a full auto rifle, so you're now basically just using a normal assault rifle, and the DM56 one turns it into a burst weapon. If your account is relatively new though, you might not have these attachments unlocked, so I'd recommend checking this ahead of time, and if you don't have them, then make sure to set them as your active armory unlocks. Once you've completed all 4 base camo challenges on a weapon, you will unlock access to the gold camo challenge. On all of the Marksman rifles except the Kar98K, you simply have to get 10 kills while using a laser attachment, and integrated lasers on sites such as the Intlas CAS-14 do work for this challenge as well. So this challenge is super free and there is nothing to say about it. For the Kar98K, however, you need to get 50 kills shortly after ADS. Use this class setup and ideally play a small map playlist to make this challenge easy. Obviously, don't hold angles while ADSing, otherwise you won't be making progress towards the challenge. So let loose, as you're free to play super fast and aggressive, which is always very fun and my favourite thing to do in Call of Duty. Small maps such as Shipment make this challenge much faster to complete, but I think at this point everyone knows that Shipment is pretty good for most camo challenges. And then once you've completed the gold challenge for 4 of the Marksman rifles, you're able to do the Forged camo challenges. And once you've got Forged on 36 weapons, you can do the Priceless camos. As the Forged and Priceless challenges are different for all the Marksman rifles, I'll do this section weapon by weapon, starting with the KVD Enforcer. For Forged, you need to get 25 one-shot, 1 kills, so use this class setup. Pretty much your only option for this one is to do it in hardcore, as the only reliable way to get one shot one kills in core is to get headshots, whereas every single kill in hardcore will count towards this challenge. This makes it one of the rare times I actively recommend hardcore over core. For priceless, you need 25 extreme magnification kills. This means you need to use any sight with 8x magnification or more. The class setup is exactly the same, just use any 8x sight such as the DXS Coriolis V4. I wouldn't recommend using any variable sights though, as it's easy to forget to toggle to the correct zoom level and you'll be wondering why no progress is being made. Up next is the MCW 6.8, and I would recommend using this class setup for the Forged challenge, which is to get 3 kills in one magazine 15 times. Unfortunately, the aftermarket conversion kit blocks the magazine slot, which means you're restricted to just 20 bullets, so we can't use that. Instead, just go to hardcore again and you'll be fine with what I've recommended. For priceless, you need to get 15 suppressed clean kills. In order to get a clean kill, you must kill an enemy without taking damage from any source. As my previous class setup already has a suppressor on it, you can either just stay in hardcore with that setup and get 15 more kills, or you can use this class setup in core, which makes use of the aftermarket conversion kit. For the DM56 Forge challenge, use this class, as you need to get 25 kills while in tac stance. Turning this weapon into a burst assault rifle helps a lot and means you're able to actually get kills fairly easily with an otherwise terrible weapon. It's super important that you do build around tac stance for challenges like this, as if you invest into the right attachments, then you're significantly more accurate than if you just use a normal class and try to get tax dance kills with that. For the Priceless challenge, you need to get 15 iron sight headshots. This is probably the hardest of all the Marksman Rifle camo challenges, especially because the aftermarket conversion kit includes a mandatory sight, so that's out of the question again. You can either grin and bear it in core, or again, hop over to hardcore and get the headshots there. This challenge is still pretty rough in hardcore though, as the iron sights are horrible, so lining up the shot before being insta-killed is actually very difficult. If you're feeling spicy, you could always try going into free-for-all and sneaking up behind enemy players to get free headshots, but to be honest, I don't think that would be worth the hassle. The next Marksman Rifle on my list is the MTZ Interceptor. The class setup for this one is the same for both camo challenges. As for Forge, you need to get 10 3 kill streaks, and then for Priceless, you need to get 5 5 kill streaks. When going for killstreak challenges, I always recommend that you need to focus on playing smart. Don't be too aggressive or impatient, especially if you've not seen anyone for a while, and absolutely don't be afraid to camp a bit when you're one kill away from making progress on the challenge. Throwing away a streak because you feel like someone might get annoyed because you're holding down an area is silly. Literally, just play the game in a way that works best for you, have fun, and ignore anyone who says otherwise. Also, using equipment and perks that help you stay alive is obviously a good idea. Trophy systems will stop you dying to random projectiles, Ghost will take you off the UAV scans, and Covert Sneakers let you move around the map without giving your position away. Generally, try and stay away from shipment or small map playlists, as they are often too chaotic to stay alive. I would play 6v6 game modes, but 10v10 can work as well. And the final Marksman Rifle currently in Modern Warfare 3 is the Kar98K. Use this class setup for the Force challenge, which is to get 2 kills shortly after sprinting 15 times. Again, if you continue with the advice I gave on how to get the gold Kar98K challenge done, this is exactly the same, except you just need to be getting 2 kills in each life. I wouldn't recommend shipment for this one though, as it's so chaotic that consistently getting even 2 kills in one life can be quite hard, especially with a weapon that's not as mobile as the SMGs everyone uses there. 10v10 playlist will be a decent place for this challenge, or 6v6 objective-based playlist will do the job as well. I always find that if there's an objective to play for, the enemies will group up and be more predictable, which makes life a lot easier. Unlike the killstreak challenges, you cannot get multiple progresses of this in one life. By which I mean, getting 4 kills shortly after aiming down sights in one life does not count as 2 progresses towards this challenge. Finally, the Kar98K Priceless Camo Challenge is to get 20 headshots while using the iron sights. Use this class setup and have fun, as this is a great test of skill that is actually quite satisfying once you get into the rhythm of things. This weapon should always one-shot kill to the head in any playlist, so no hardcore is needed. Happy days. I want this to be the most comprehensive guide to getting Priceless Marksman Rifles there is, so if you have any extra tips that you think I missed out, then be sure to share them in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, then the best way to show me is by leaving a like. That way I know to make more content like this. Thank you for being here, and good luck on your camo grind.